Hi, I'm assuming you have an annoying problem, which is this. And in this video, I'm going to be sharing with you three things that you can possibly do to get rid of this no signal problem. To begin with, I'm assuming that your PC and your monitor are in good working condition. If not, you want to get subscribed to my mailing list so you can receive the best offers of used PCs. Perhaps you want to consider buying a new one altogether. So first things first, you want to make sure the monitor cable is connected to the right graphic port on the PC. In this case, we have a Dell Optiplex PC with a dedicated AMD graphic card. If this is the case, unfortunately, you will not receive any signal on your monitor as the cable has been wrongly plugged to the graphic port on the main board. So you have to unplug the monitor cable, a HDMI cable in this case, and plug it onto the HDMI port of the graphic card. At this point, you may want to restart the PC to ensure that the signal detection initiates properly. Secondly, go into the settings tab of your monitor and ensure that the correct input source has been selected. So in this case, I will select HDMI, given that I'm connecting my monitor to the PC via a HDMI cable. If, however, your monitor has an auto switch input function, you may want to switch this on as well, as this will ensure that the monitor selects the appropriate input source that is being thrown at it at any time. So if you've tried the first two troubleshoots and you still have no signal, then you may want to try out the next step. Proceed by switching off the PC. Thereafter, open up the side cover and locate the RAM sticks and carefully take it out. In doing this, you want to push back the white, blue, or black clips holding the RAM sticks in place. Not doing this may result in a damage to your RAM sticks and, in worst case scenario, your motherboard. So properly clean the RAM sticks with microfiber cloth with a little dose of isopropyl alcohol. Allow a few minutes to dry, then replace the RAM sticks and thereafter switch on your PC. If, however, this doesn't solve the problem, then you want to go ahead and check this video here as it shows you how you can troubleshoot a failing RAM on a desktop PC. Until I see you again, peace.